What's goody, Barons?
On today's episode, we'll watch the first edition of the Barons Debate League.
Watch a video about MSP.
Tune in to see what Camilo has in store for this week of Hispanic Heritage Month. See who's best at finishing songs.
And get a special message from Dr. Jones.
I'm Maya Broadwater.
And I'm Pierre Vasquez.
And you're watching BCC TV. So, Piero, what's going on in the news this week?
An Indonesian teenager was rescued after 49 days lost at sea on a floating fish trap. The teen was living on and operating a fish trap when the rope anchoring the trap broke and strong winds blew him roughly 1,200 miles away into Japanese waters. He floated for nearly 2 months on the trap. He is now reunited with his family and in good condition.
A second woman has come forward accusing of Supreme Court Judge nominee Brett Kavanaugh of sexual misconduct. In response, Judge Kavanaugh has vowed to not withdraw from his nomination and accepting any investigation requiring these claims.
In BCC News, not much is going on. However, online ticket sales for the homecoming dance start today.
But congratulations to the student body for making it through our very first full week of school.
Seriously, we're proud of you.
In all seriousness, come out to the football game tonight against Churchill.
Sport your blue and gold and bring all your Baron pride. It's going to be lit.
Anyways, have you heard of the Barons Debate League?
No.
Bet, me neither. Let's check it out anyways.
Hello, Barons. Welcome to Baron Debate League. I'm your host, Ben Moran.
Baron Debate League, Baron Debate League, Baron Debate League, yeah.
The BDL is a school-wide year-round competition. There are four teams, staff, Class of 2019, 2020, and 2021. Each edition, one representative from two of the teams will go head-to-head in a debate. After each debate, the four judges will vote for the winner. I will break any ties to decide the winner, because I'm the host.
Representing Class of 2019, Logan Patterson. Representing the underclassmen, Will McCollum. The topic today, is Batman a superhero? Let's start off with Class of 2019.
Batman, obviously a superhero, come on. He's got comics written about him. He has a utility belt. This kid, he goes out there, he takes down the Joker. He takes down the crocodile dude. Like, oh my God, this kid is incredible. He got the batarangs.
Time. Oh.
All right, so he's coming out here saying Batman's obviously a superhero because he has comics written about him. I wouldn't say he's a superhero. I'd say he's a hero. Definition of a superhero is someone who has superhuman-like abilities. Batman just knows karate and makes frisbees in a cave. I wouldn't say that gives him superpowers.
I'm done. No, I can't do this anymore.
Awesome.
I can.
Will can.
I can do this. Logan stating that Batman goes out there and fights super villains. Maybe these villains do have powers. Batman does not. He's just a man who has a lot of money to make these gadgets.
Will, out here trying to tell me that, like, he's not a superhero. The guy has just inhumane strength. He is out there just breaking so much stuff. He's breaking people's faces with his fist. Superhuman intellect, superhuman instincts. Like the guy, he's got the instincts of a bat, man. He's just out there like going crazy, like doing it to everyone. He's insane.
Let's put it off to Will.
All right.
Let's end this debate out. Let's see how it goes.
All right, Logan's saying that he has instincts and superhuman strength that he actually does not have. He's not Spider-Man. He has no Spidey sense. Maybe he has something in his suit that can help him here or give him enhanced abilities.
Judges, you've heard the cases.
I'm gonna have to say that Batman, not a superhero.
Mr. McCollum made some strong points about the suit and his money, but the utility belt is just a strong argument. I'm gonna have to go with the fact that Batman is a superhero.
Batman is not a superhero.
I'm gonna have to go with, I think he is a superhero. I think Iron Man, same situation.
This is the first time in history where the host is gonna break the tie. I'm gonna give this one to Logan and Class of 2019.
Thank you, everyone.
If you wanna participate, DM, Instagram, BCC TV, be an arguer, tell us why you can argue. If you wanna be a judge, tell us why you can judge. If you wanna be a host, sorry, I'm the host.
I've never even thought about the possibility of Batman not being a superhero.
Me neither, but come to think of it, there are two sides of every story.
Now, we know last week you guys didn't get to see how extraordinary the Minority Scholars Program is.
But now it's really time to get woke. Let's see what MSP is all about.
If you'd like to be a part of MSP, meetings are at lunch once a month on Wednesdays in the chorus room.
Now, today marks the end of the second week of Hispanic Heritage Month.
This week, we'll be talking about Latino immigration and its impact in our society.
Let's take a look at what Camilo has put together for us this week.
Pero acuérdense una cosa, que América es un continente. Y todo el que nace en América es americano. No es solamente un grupo. Todo el que nace en el continente americano es americano. Igual que todo el que nace en el continente europeo es europeo.
A new report shows the number of immigrants arriving in the U.S. last year hitting a record high. There are an estimated 11 million immigrants in the U.S. illegally.
1.8 million new immigrants settling in the U.S. in 2016, highest level in U.S. history.
They are being released by the tens of thousands into our communities with no regard for the impact on public safety or resources.
I got one job, two jobs, three when I need them. I got five.
At the age of six, I crossed the border illegally with my family. And I lived in this country illegally until I was 14 years old. Now imagine being that young and going to school every single day. And every single day, no matter what you do and no matter how hard you try to focus on your classes, you have this little thought in the back of your mind. And that thought is my mother going to be home when I get off the bus this afternoon?
Por tierra o por agua, identidad falsa. Brincamos muros o flotamos en balsa. La peleamos como Sandino en Nicaragua. Somos como las plantas que crecen sin agua.
And the Oscar goes to?
And the Academy Award for Achievement in Directing goes to?
The Latin Grammy goes to?
The Oscar goes to?
Alejandro G. Inarritu.
Guillermo del Toro.
Celia Cruz.
I am an immigrant, like many, many of you. And in the last 25 years, I've been living in a country all of our own.
This award is so much more than myself. It represents a culture that wants to see themselves as heroes.
Y que no solo enriquecen la vida cultural del país, sino que aportan valores apoyados en su propia dignidad, en el trabajo duro, el sacrificio y el poderoso regusto de sentirse unidos contra nadie.
Immigrants, we get the job done.
Thanks for that, Camilo.
You know what's crazy?
What?
We finish each other's
sandwiches.
Hey, that's what I was gonna say.
I've never met someone who thinks so much like me.
Honestly, like, same. Like,
no, Piero, you were supposed to finish the song, bruh.
Music. Music is everywhere. Music is in Brazil, in France, and if you see me in the hallways, you already know it's in my ears. If you know me, you know I should be signed already. At Good Music. Let's see if you can even finish these lyrics. I've been cooking it up in the booth for ages now. What you been doing? Scoop!
Sweet Caroline.
I don't know the lyrics.
You will not believe your eyes.
And a million fireflies.
My guy pretty like a girl. And he got vice.
Yeah.
I see both sides.
Young Sheck West, and I'm getting really
rich.
Young Sheck West.
She's in love with who I am.
She's in love with who I am.
No, fool, you have to continue it.
Oh.
I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
M's in my bank account.
She's in love with who I am.
Back in high school, I used to bust it to the dance.
Taylor, I got 84. Get that right there. Zoom in.
901 Shelby Drive.
Look alive, look alive.
901 Shelby Drive. Look alive.
All right, we're gonna have Sad Boy out.
I still see your shadows in my room. Can't take back the love that I gave you. It's to the point where I love and I hate you. And I cannot change you, so I must replace you. Easier said than done, I thought you were the one. Listen.
Are you ready, kids?
Aye, aye, Captain!
I can hear you!
Aye, aye, Captain!
Ooh! Who lives in a pineapple under the sea?
New panic on my...
I don't know that song.
What is that?
I'm not doing
it.
No.
Yeah. Stop.
What about Justin Bieber?
Just...
Miley Cyrus.
No.
That was Lil Uzi Vert.
Chief called. This ain't it. Y'all ain't on my level. I'm headed back to Astroworld. Back to you, Maya.
I'm not the only one who's bad at finishing songs.
Yeah, but there were still some people who pulled through.
True. Now, with school starting up again, administration has a few messages for us parents.
Let's check in with Dr. Jones to hear what she has to say. Hey, Barons, we have had a great 3 weeks of school. I was so impressed with all of the outstanding clubs and organizations out at the Activities Fair on last week. So much to get involved with at BCC. I hope everyone has decided on some club, organization, athletic activity, something to really hook into at BCC High School. All right, got a few updates for you. First, I want to make sure that all students are taking advantage of TAP. This is Time for Academic Progress. It's an after-school academic help program, Tuesdays, Wednesdays, Thursdays. Math and science will be C-109. English and social studies will be C-112. Take advantage of getting extra help from BCC teachers on these days. And I wanted to talk to you about homecoming. So, homecoming is coming up. The game is going to actually be on Friday, October 12th, and the dance is going to be on October 13th. So I heard there was a nasty rumor out there, Barons, that you couldn't bring guests. No way. You can bring guests, but the first 2 days of ticket sales will be for BCC students only. That's just to make sure that all BCC students get the chance to buy tickets. So just the first 2 days of ticket sales. After that, it's wide open, Barons, but you do need to make sure you have the guest form. And as usual, everybody signs that we're committed to having a safe event. Have a great day, Barons. Thanks for the checkup, Doctor.
It's been a dove-filled sports week, thanks to our Baron athletes.
What's going on with Baron sports this week, Jeremiah?
Hey, Barons, it's been an action-packed sports week. First off, football got their first win of the season, crushing Northwood 55-20. Congrats to Coach Minturn and the rest of the team on their first win of the season. Let's do it again tonight against Churchill. Then, girls hockey beat RM 4-0 in their last game. Don't forget to come out to support the girls field hockey team either tonight at 7 versus Wooten or Whitman on Saturday at 10 a.m. Cross country had a muddy game against Whitman on Tuesday, but Aiden and Roslyn overcame the slippery slopes, taking the individual dubs, winning boys and girls varsity. Girls volleyball won their Dig Pink game against WJ Tuesday night with incredible Baron spirit behind them. And don't forget to come out to the boys soccer game this Saturday at 2 p.m. versus Kennedy. Well, that's all for this week, Barons. Back to you, Maya and Piero.
Thanks for that, Jeremiah.
Well, that's all for this episode, Barons. Check back next week for more news, updates, and humor.
Keep those standards high, BCC.
And keep the 19 girls jersey beef low.
I'm Maya Broadwater.
And I'm Piero Vasquez.
And we're signing off.